afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Pepsi Stadium on the campus of North Greenville University, where Christ makes the difference for today's conference matchup between the Lees-McRae Bobcats and your North Greenville Crusaders. Now, for today's starting lineups. First, for the Bobcats. At goalkeeper, number 1, Tyler Pavlett. At defender, number 6, Marvin Reiger. At midfielder, number 7, Nathan Watt. At midfielder, number 8, Anders Stokes. At forward, number 9, Paul Vassart. At midfielder, number 19, Thomas Dealey. At midfielder, number 11, Palais Jesperson. At forward, number 14, Taylor Gray. At defender, number 18, Zachary Clay. At defender, number 20, Kelvin Woods. And at defender, number 36, James Morgan. The Bobcats are coached by Rich Wall, and he is assisted by Seth Lowther. And now, the starting lineup for your North Greenville Crusaders. At goalkeeper, number 1, Mateo Barzala. At defender, number 3, Sam Robertson. At midfielder, number 4, Marlon Evans. At defender, number 5, Lucas Gravely. At forward, number 6, Jonathan Lynn. At forward, number 7, Vitor Tarpinian. At midfielder, number 8, David Becerra. At defender, number 11, Juan Carlos Regalado. At forward, number 16, Matthew Woodington. At defender, number 19, Jake Quinn. And at midfielder, number 21, Casey Brady. Your Crusaders are coached by Bill Martin. He is assisted by assistant coach, Coach Baker. At this time, we ask that you please rise for the invocation and please remain standing as we honor America with the playing of our national anthem. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we come to you today to thank you for these athletes and their talents that you have given them. Please keep them safe in their contest. We thank you for all the supporting fans, spectators, and parents alike for the support that they give these athletes and the university. We pray that you keep everyone safe here and on the drive home, and that you be glorified. In your name I pray. Amen.
And welcome back for game two of this doubleheader, soccer doubleheader here on this Wednesday night here on the North Greenville Sports Network. Grace Sutherland back with Dave Parson to bring you the men's game between North Greenville and Lees-McRae. And Dave, you brought to my attention, we forgot to go over one more detail before we closed out the women's broadcast, and that was where the two teams were heading next.
Lees-McRae Bobcats, they'll be going Saturday at Erskine and Due West for a 2 o'clock game. And the Lady Crusaders are going to be going to Barton College on Saturday also at a 2 p.m. game.
And the next home soccer broadcast looks to be September 24th. It's a Saturday against Limestone. That's the next home game.
And, again, that'll be a doubleheader, the men's and women's game.
I think you are right on that call as well. So here we have the men's teams in action. North Greenville looking for their first win on the season, coming in tonight 0-2 after a 2-1 loss against Newberry, that one in overtime, and then last time out on Saturday, September the 10th, a 5-1 loss to Erskine. So North Greenville looking for their first win overall and first conference win. Meanwhile, Lees-McRae comes in tonight looking for some more positive momentum. They are looking to pick up their second win of the season, much like their women's teams. They come in tonight 1-3, but also like their women's team, they still have a perfect conference record after getting an early season conference win.
Yeah, Gray, and they also, in their four games, have posted 8 goals, or a goals per game average of 2, and a shots per game at 10.3.
And 2 losses for the Bobcats coming in overtime. So Lees-McRae, men's soccer, taking them down to the wire here to start off the 2016-17 season.
Again, it's a beautiful Wednesday night, September the 14th, 2016. Good crowd on the other side. Again, we welcome you to the North Greenville Sports Network. Glad that you're with us tonight and hope you'll enjoy tonight's game.
And a little bit cooler.
And a little cooler.
Well, a little bit cooler now that the sun is finally set behind us. So North Greenville in their white and black uniforms. Lees-McRae coming out in green and white. Number one, Mateo Barzola out of Argentina, back in net for North Greenville.
And Bobcats have a lot of players, Gray, that are not native to the United States. We're good to see a good representation from around the world.
They do. Some from Germany. You've got some from England. One from the Netherlands on there. But North Greenville also has a Dutch player in number 27, Shores Vanek. And number one, Tyler Pavlett out of Goodyear, Arizona, back in net for Lees-McRae. So opening minutes here between the Bobcats and the Crusaders. Number 20, that's Kelvin Woods. Passing it with number seven, Nathan Watt, one of those international players. Nathan Watt out of Newcastle, United Kingdom. So Newcastle, England, out of the UK. Down the middle of the field, Bobcats looking to strike early. Over to the near side for number 14, Taylor Gray. Trying to work it inside the box, number 10, Thomas Dealey is not open. Into the corner, they flip it back outside. Nathan Watt is there. All right, Nathan Watt tries a cross, headed away by North Greenville. And now number 6, Jonathan Lind, will try and start the counterattack. And several defenders getting in the way. Number 1, Paulet Jesperson getting in the way. And now Lees-McRae, Barzola has to come up and make the quick stop. He does. As Lees-McRae didn't quite have the breakaway with number 9, Paul Vassart, but they were close to. Now another long shot down the field, headed away by number 6, Marvin Reiger, from defender from Frankfurt, Germany. And now North Greenville will try and start the counterattack. Lees-McRae bringing pressure on the ball again. Barzola looks to the far side, goes that way to number 3, Sam Robertson. And it's out of bounds, and a throw in to the Bobcats. North Greenville able to dispose of the throw in before it can do any damage. North Greenville trying to get the breakaway, no such doing. Pass cut away by number 18, Zachary Clay. North Greenville tries again. Number 21, Casey Brady, gets the ball back. Pass to the near side for Juan Carlos Regalado. Brady intercepted by Gray. He'll hand off. Cross midfield goes Vassart. Vassart gives it up again. Now number 11, Jesperson, gives it back. North Greenville cuts away the backheel pass. Crusaders back on the attack. Brady with it. Passes to the near side for Carlos Regalado. Regalado looking to go long. Number 7, Vitor Tarpinian on the move. And defended well by the keeper, Pavlett. And number 20, Woods.
Much quicker pace, Gray, than we have in the ladies' game.
Both teams trying to strike early and put the other team on the back hill. North Greenville defends that potential threat. And a long shot is over the crossbar from number 7, Nathan Watt.
Barzola watched it go over, and he was ready.
North Greenville coached by first-year head coach Bill Martin. And Lees-McRae coached by Rich Wall. North Greenville with it on the far side. Back to the keeper, Barzola. Try the near side. Number 19, Jake Quinn, is there. Number 21, Brady. And Brady gets picked, but Barzola is there as Thomas Dealey provided some pressure and upset Brady. Now Greenville trying to attack down the far side again. number 5, Lucas Gravely, on the far side in his defender spot. Passes back to number 4, Marlon Evans. Forward to Brady in the middle of the field. Lees-McRae giving space to Brady. Chips it up, looking to the near side for Regalado. Regalado just gets beaten to the ball by his defender, and it's chased out of bounds by Zachary Clay. And that will be a throw-in for North Greenville, just shy of the corner flag. Brady trying to get out of the corner, splits two defenders, chips it up, had an open man in the box, is cleared for the moment by Lees-McRae. And now sent high to the near side and somehow kept in bounds by number 7, Nathan Watt. North Greenville gets to it first with Gravely, but that sets the Crusaders back a lot of field position. Now North Greenville attacking down the far side, able to keep pace ahead of the Lees-McRae defenders. Brady gets to it. Now here's Evans, chips it up looking for Tarpinian, and Tarpinian is offside. Vitor Tarpinian, junior forward out of Atibaia, Brazil. And now Nathan Watt. Dealey. And good sliding challenge there. And it will go back to the Crusaders. Credit Regalado for that stop. Now here's Quinn getting away from the pressure, back to his keeper Barzola. Barzola switches to the far side for Gravely. Gravely brings it up, chips it to the middle of the field for Brady, and Brady gets chased down, able to keep his footing and turns the ball over. Now Lees-McRae on the counterattack. They have numbers forward into the edge of the box, and they'll try and chip it back to the middle. Nothing doing, well defended by Marlon Evans as Pele Jesperson has a look. Gravely again, back to Evans, who just came up with a big stop. To Barzola, and Barzola almost got left hung out to dry. Now Brady with it. Passes it forward at the last moment. Regalado looking for his open man. Number 16, Matthew Woodington, bounces up. And once again, Lees-McRae is able to get it out of the box. Nathan Watt runs him down, and the offside flag goes up against North Greenville. That will be a free kick.
Hey, Matthew, good stuff. Come on, let's go.
Number 16, Matthew Woodington, forward freshman out of Taylor's, South Carolina, getting a good look at the open net, but Nathan Watt coming up with a defensive stop. Lees-McRae will look to move forward. Watt passing forward to Taylor Gray. Gray goes backwards, and North Greenville will have a good chance for a counterattack. Down the left wing in a foot race, and it's stopped by Kelvin Woods, who puts North Greenville back almost to midfield, but the Crusaders retain it with a throw-in.
Once again, Gray, very defensive battle tonight.
Well, Lees-McRae able to keep pace and not let North Greenville get away. As Woodington in a foot race again, stopped and cleared by Lees-McRae. Number 20, Kelvin Woods again. North Greenville again. Brady for the far side for number 3, Sam Roberson. Now Lees-McRae steals it away again, and no harm, no foul against the Bobcats.
Good.
Bobcats start anew. Number 8, Anders Stokes to Nathan Watt. Watt, long pass down the middle of the field, has a man, Dealey. He's on size, tries to get a good shot, and Barzola makes the stop. Good save by Barzola, and we remain scoreless. Lees-McRae again, cuts it away. Now down the near side, Watt's there. Trying to bring it into the box, chips it up, and barely misses his man, Vassart, who was open on the far side. And now another shot into the box. Lees-McRae has attackers there. Again, defended by Marlon Evans, and Barzola with the sliding stop. And North Greenville will try to get numbers forward to perform a quick counterattack. North Greenville stuffs it out with Regalado. Now Tarpinian breaks free down the near side. He needs some help, though. And Woods, again, able to guard Tarpinian and send it out. North Greenville with a throw-in, though.
Coming into the game for number 16, Matthew Woodington, is number 12, Chris Inman for the Crusaders.
See our first substitution as well. Chris Inman will come in for Matthew Woodington.
Crusaders' Chris Inman comes to us out of Lexington, Kentucky.
Throw in from Regalado will find Inman for his first touch, and he tried to get it back to Regalado, cut away by the defender for Lees-McRae. North Greenville trying to get it back. Evans got a foot in there, and North Greenville gets it back, but they're forced all the way back to their keeper, Barzola, in his sophomore campaign. Gravely over on the far side. No holes for him or Evans. Now Gravely sends it forward, defended well by number 11, Jesperson. Jesperson chips it up looking for Vassart. And again, defended by North Greenville and Evans. Now here comes number 14, Taylor Gray. Crosses into the box, and Barzola comes up to stop the loose ball from bouncing off anybody else. Had four different Bobcats in the box, and somehow that ball missed making contact with any of them.
Crusaders are getting a break on their end of the field, that's for sure.
Now one-on-one situation, Tarpinian going up against Clay. Clay wins the battle for the moment, but North Greenville will have a throw-in.
I think you took an inadvertent elbow to the eye, and I think you'll just shake it off.
Regalado for the throw-in, finds number 12, Inman, a whistle. And timeout, officials timeout for Tarpinian.
Stopping the clock at 31:06 in this first half.
Official coming over to check on Tarpinian. Tarpinian says he's okay. Continues on. I think you're right, Dave. Did take a elbow to the left eye. But he stays in. Now defender for Lees-McRae getting trapped in the corner. Number 14, Taylor Gray, running out of real estate. And it's finally pushed out by North Greenville. And a goal kick for the Bobcats with Pavlett.
I think the referee called that a frozen ball, Gray. It sort of looked like he kind of was holding it in the corner. Didn't keep the ball moving.
Lees-McRae to midfield. Now backwards into their defensive half. Back to midfield. Number 7, Nathan Watt chips a long pass down the field, and the offside flag goes up. Number 10, Thomas Dealey, a little too far out in front. And now Nathan Watt, again, long shot, will miss this one very wide right. And a goal kick for Barzola. It's So Lees-McRae, the stat line favors the Bobcats early. Already two shots, one of those on goal. And Barzola already having to come up and make at least one save. No goal scored, though, 15 minutes in.
Bobcats having a hurry-up offense.
Already back across midfield, number nine, Vassart. Forward, looking for Stokes. Can't find him. The Bobcats turn it over. And Watt intercepts the ball away from number eight, David Becerra. Now North Greenville, they have three men forward, but the defenders for Lees-McRae race ahead and kick it out of bounds. Number 36, James Morgan, from his defender position, junior out of Newcastle, England as well. Gravely heads it back to his keeper, Barzola, and Barzola gets rid of it in the face of Vassart. Gravely on the far side, slings a pass down the sideline, picked up by Lees-McRae. Bobcats head back the other way as James Morgan again on the defensive stop. Now the Bobcats working with the room they have, Jesperson. And they have a man wide open here on the near side. Clay with some room to run. They keep it on the far side, pass chipped up to the edge of the box. Headed away by Regalado and tracked back down by Gray for the Bobcats. Goes back to number seven, Watt. Now Watt makes a move, passes back right, has Gray. Gray at the edge of the box, crosses in, and here comes a shot. Barzola makes a leg save, and it's cleared by North Greenville.
Good save that time.
Trying to squeeze it in between the keeper and that post right in that bottom left corner. Barzola stretched out for it, and very good stop.
Yeah, he was fortunate that that ball was just on the ground level.
And it's exactly right, as here comes the cross in. High cross. This one's going to clear almost everybody. Headed back in, and Barzola will reach up for it and snag it. Now he'll hang on to it and let some attackers race forward before he lets go of it, and we're back underway. Lees-McRae with two men forward as make it three, and now one's dropping back in as here comes Brady. And now Regalado. Good pass there to Tarpinian. Tarpinian tracked down though by Watt. Who's it out of bounds off of? Watt, and it'll be a throw in for NGU.
Bobcats showing great speed going back to the ball. I'm really impressed with their speed.
Number eight, David Becerra, as number 25, Evan Mills.
Substitution
Crusaders.
Again for North Greenville. We have number 25, Evan Mills, will be coming in for Becerra. Throw in for Regalado. And at a disadvantage in the corner is Tarpinian. It's kicked out, and North Greenville sets up for their first corner of the game with just under 26 minutes to go until halftime. Regalado to take the kick.
There are no Crusaders in front of the goal. I'm kind of surprised.
Line drive kick, it's low, bounced up off a defender's foot. Gravely heads it back in and headed back out. Now the Bobcats have an opportunity for a breakaway. Good sliding challenge by Gravely, but the Bobcats keep it going. Number 14, Gray, drives into the box. He'll need some help, and again, the ball slung into the woods as it's deflected off number three, Sam Roberson. And somebody's going to have some work to do to go get that one.
Yeah, that one's down the valley.
And they're already sending somebody after it.
I hope he has a flashlight.
Going to need it. Corner kick for the Bobcats. This one is on target and then off target, off the head of number 7, Nathan Watt. He was behind everybody, and he had half of the right side of the goal to aim for.
Well, the guy looking for the ball out in the woods does have a flashlight, but with those shorts on, I don't think he wants to go down there too far.
Mm-hmm. I wouldn't either. Well, now they've got three out there.
Yeah, they'll pick that up tomorrow.
Here's Mills, Roberson, Regalado, as all kinds of pressure being applied by Lees-McRae. You've got Vessert and Dealey running around the tail end of the field, and looks like it's worked, a throw-in for Lees-McRae.
Yeah, a little miscue there on the goaltender, kicking that one completely out of bounds.
Gravely coming up to try and intercept the pass. Looks like he got it. Gives it to Brady. They go to Mills. Mills back to Regalado. Now number 12, Chris Inman. Inman down the field. Doesn't have anybody open. And now Barzola has to field the loose ball after number 10, Dealey, got a foot in there and jarred it loose. Now Regalado. And kicked out of bounds off the foot of Taylor Gray, throwing Crusaders. Tarpinian, again, deflected out of bounds off a defender. North Greenville keep working their way down the sideline. Again, kicked out of bounds by a defender. Regalado for the throw-in.
Well, they're gaining momentum going down the field on the sideline.
Yeah. Regalado, third throw in again, finds Mills. Mills kicks it back to midfield. Now North Greenville forced to give ground. Back to the keeper, Barzola, far side. And lands at the feet of a Bobcat. Bobcats quickly turn to offense. Nathan Watt chips it up, far side. Headed back into the box, but nobody home for Lees-McRae. Barzola will come up to make the stop.
Higher 22 minutes to go in the first half.
Mills able to steal it away from Gray. Lees-McRae, three attackers forward, trying to jar the ball loose. North Greenville's got to find somebody open downfield. Here's Mills. And now back to the keeper, Barzola. Right side for Quinn. Quinn to Mills, cut away by Watt. Sliding challenge missed by Quinn. Open space for Watt. Left side edge of the box, looks for the cross, deflected away. Watt gets it back, they line it up. Here comes the shot, Barzola with the hand save, and it's high and out.
Yeah, good jump, timed it just right.
We'll give Lees-McRae a corner.
I know I've said it before, Gray, but I'm really impressed with Lees-McRae's speed. They're definitely outrunning the Crusaders.
And the pressure is all on the keeper, Barzola, his fourth save of the game. Still 20 minutes to go. The cross in, headed up and high over the crossbar. Now who touched it? Looks like the Bobcats will line up for a second corner.
And an update on the ball in the woods. It looks like they've recovered the ball.
Yes, they did. This time a pass, they flip it back. Now the cross, headed away by Evans. Now with Greenville trying to get that breakaway, see if they can pull away from that Lees-McRae speed. Down the near side, Roberson flips it up, and now Inman turns on the burners. And he does battle with Taylor Gray. Taylor Gray wins and gets it to Nathan Watt. Now back to Gray off the pass from number 10, Thomas Dealey. Gray chips it down the field. Number 11, Jesperson. Regalado steps in the passing lane, forces Lees-McRae to start again. Brait. Stokes. Pressure being applied by North Greenville again. They have to go all the way back to the keeper, Pavlett. To Woods. Chris Inman goes for the interception, gets it. Now here comes Regalado looking back for Inman. Inman can't get to the ball in time. And he might be able to steal it away from Nathan Watt. And the ball is right on the sideline, and somehow Nathan Watt keeps it in and heads back the other direction.
Bobcats number 14, Taylor Gray, a forward, only a freshman out of Hughesville, Maryland. Very impressive with his speed.
Playing very well. He's gotten a couple of well-targeted crosses in the box, as nobody's been able to find the aim once he's done that. Brady goes for the sliding challenge, comes up empty, deflected off of a Bobcat after the challenge from Jonathan Lind. And now North Greenville with the throw in.
Bobcats roster is only showing four seniors, Gray. Got a lot of potential with this young team.
Yeah, a lot. A lot of freshmen and sophomores on this Bobcat team, and they're already quick. Boy, if they imagine if they somehow manage to find more speed out of the squad. Deflected out of bounds. North Greenville with the throw in. See if the official allows the substitutions. Doesn't look like he's gonna. Regalado throws it in. Inman to midfield. Bobcats intercept. Number 9, Vassart. Number 11, Jesperson. Back to Watt. Watt, Jesperson. Man open. Here's number 10, that's Dealey. Dealey looking for a spot to fire from. Kicks it up for Stokes, who's come up to help him out. Stokes being chased into the corner by Tarpinian. Stokes has to give it back outside the box. Lees-McRae, here comes the cross, and it's headed left. Ooh, and the offside flag went up as the shot was taken. So Lees-McRae's speed, too quick that time.
A little bit too quick, yep. They'll get it figured out here. Again, this is a very young team.
Out of bounds over on the far side. Lees-McRae unable to handle it. Throwing Crusaders.
Crusaders going to take advantage of field position along the sideline again like they did on the near side.
Ball bouncing all the way back to the keeper. Barzoli's able to get to it. Mills. Regalado. And good pass there to Inman down the sideline. Inman's covered, though, and it's kicked out of bounds. Woods got to it, but Crusaders set up for the throw-in. Back to midfield, Quinn, Lind. A challenge by Gray to put a foot in there, and now Quinn sends it long down the field to force Lees-McRae to reset. Work it in the middle of the field, number 8, Stokes. Back to Woods, now 18, Clay, long down the field over everybody's heads. Barzola will let it go out for a goal kick. Now the substitution allowed in for Lees-McRae, number 28.
Coming into the
Taylor
game,
Morton.
Bobcats is number 28, Taylor Morton.
Out of Pinehurst, North Carolina.
Switch him in for, looks like 18.
Obviously chosen soccer instead of golf.
Yeah, sometimes you have to.
Well, maybe he's a multiplayer, maybe he plays both.
Yeah, you can do that. Got a lot of multi-sport athletes, football, basketball. I don't see a problem with playing soccer and golf.
As long as you don't kick the golf ball with your foot.
Yeah, don't try that. No telling where that thing will go.
Impressed with the Bobcats swarming defense when North Greenville has the ball. It seems like there's always two or three players around that ball.
Yeah, they're really a great pursuit by the Bobcats. You are exactly right on that. Throw in for the Bobcats, under 15 minutes to go until the half. So both teams see if they can get a late first half goal to seal up some momentum, go into halftime, and give a reason for either coach to smile about. Headed back away by Regalado. Bobcats retreat to retrieve the ball. Number 7, Watt has it. Goes back to 20 Woods, or 28. That is Morton, who's just come in. Now back to Watt.
14 minutes left in the first half.
Now Lind has to go out over it to cover Gray. Gray's into the box, still has a foot on it. And both players go down in the box. And it will be a corner kick for Lees-McRae as Taylor Gray and Jake Quinn got tangled up.
Once again, Gray, we appreciate our viewers joining us on the North Greenville Sports Network this evening. Men's soccer.
This cross line drive bounced off of the Lees-McRae Bobcat, and Barzola was right there to cover it. Almost like that Bobcat attacker wasn't expecting it.
Exactly.
Now this a long shot down the field. Man open here on the near side for the Bobcats. Number 10, Dealey, trying to find some space. Has a pass deflected up by Regalado. Now Barzola almost had to come up and make the save. His defensive line able to get rid of it before Barzola has to get to it. Now Brady gets the loose ball to Inman. Inman, a clear pass. And the keeper, Pavlik, came way up to put a stop to that.
Great play. Great play by the goalkeeper.
As Casey Brady would have been long and gone and had the keeper all to himself.
Right, he would have had an open goal there. But goalkeeper definitely was in right position.
Tyler Pavlik with the late first half stop. Now Lees-McRae right back the other way, trying to get numbers forward. Pass to the far side. Here comes across into the box, deflected off of, I believe Quinn stuck his right leg out there, and Barzola makes the save.
Barzola very effective tonight.
Now North Greenville trying to chip up another long pass, and it's out of bounds off of NGU. As great pursuit, just wrong place. Now Lees-McRae breaking through again. Barzola off his mark, and it goes in.
I'm afraid Barzola got a little bit farther away from the goal than he should have been on that one.
A little too anxious trying to come up and cut the angle. Number 9, Paul Vassart, a forward out of Arnhem, the Netherlands.
And once again, we're starting this game just like we did the ladies' game earlier today.
So the Bobcats come down here from Banner Elk, North Carolina, right on the state line between North Carolina and Tennessee. Now North Greenville finds themselves down one, trying to find the equalizer before the half. Throwing for the Bobcats. And can the Bobcats continue to use their great speed, or will they eventually wear out?
Crusaders have got to get some shots on goal, Gray.
According to the stat sheet, not even a shot for North Greenville.
Right, yep. They got to get that offense going.
Lees-McRae right back in business, into the corner. Morton with the cross, slightly off target, deflected up by number 3, Sam Roberson, but Lees-McRae retains possession. Meanwhile, Lees-McRae, even though they only have one goal on the scoreboard, they've already taken 9 shots. 6 of those have been on goal. Nathan Watt, right back into the attacking half. Morton again, goes to Dealey. Dealey looking for the cross at the last moment and just missed number 9. Vassard again for a second goal, and this shot sails. Well, right back into the woods.
Well, at least they know where to look.
Roughly the same area, a little bit more to the right, though. Another substitution getting ready to come on. Here comes 14 Taylor Gray off for a rest. And 2 onto the field. The midfielder forward, David Frederick.
Nine and a half minutes to go in the first half.
Frederick, a junior on this team. And referee stops play. A foul against North Greenville will set Lees-McRae up with decent field position for this free kick. Watt to Frederick getting his first touch after coming in. Frederick bounces off a defender and cleared away by Gravely. Right back into business go the Bobcats. Good back heel there to number 11. Jesperson chased into the corner by Gravely. And Gravely kicks it out. Strategic placement. And Lees-McRae will have to have a throw in instead of a corner. Gravely gets rid of it again, finds Inman. And now a foot race down the far sideline. North Greenville trying to get it away from the Lees-McRae defenders as it's bounced off Watt, who brings it down.
Bobcats seem to be right in those passing lanes.
There's Morton. And now North Greenville able to force a bad pass, but it gets to Frederick. Frederick into the box, fires a shot, and not a problem for Paul Vassart, who picks up goal number 2. And don't think anybody saw him coming off the right post by the time the pass got to him from Frederick. He was open and about 2 inches away from the goal line.
Yeah, just a little chip in for him.
So just over eight minutes to go here in the first half, 2-0. Lees-McRae leads it, and Paul Vassart will be going for a hat trick in this game.
Crusaders, Joe Server, number 18 in the game now from High Point, North Carolina.
Good to see Severs back in the game. Here's 19 Quinn on defense, getting it to Barzola now. Now for North Greenville, something to do before the half, just get down the field and take a shot. And Barzola swings one wide again and curling right away, curling to the right, never had a chance to get to Sam Roberson, and that sets Lees-McRae up with a throw in. And Johnny Lind able to step in the passing lane that time to Mills. Back to Quinn. North Greenville again trying to attack down the far sideline. There goes Inman breaking free again, and he collides with the keeper. And the official blows his whistle, and it is against North Greenville. And Inman is down close to the far sideline after the collision with Tyler Pavlett. Training staff head out to attend to him. He gets up under his own power, and the training staff turns around and comes back.
May have just had the wind knocked out of him. That was a vicious hit.
Official checking with him. He'll stay in the game and play on. Meantime, Lees-McRae with the free kick off the foul.
Referee's satisfied. He knows it's Wednesday.
Lees-McRae, here comes a long pass. Takes a hop, spins to the near side edge of the box. Number two, Frederick, sends the cross in. And bounced out of bounds by number 18, Joe Severs, with the potential goal saver on that one. Not out of the woods yet as Lees-McRae goes for the corner kick. The cross short, bounced back to Barzola, who makes the save. Runs forward and wheels it around the defender. North Greenville on the counterattack. And kicked out by Morton. That will stall North Greenville. They keep the ball out with a throw in. Number four, Evans. It strips. Number seven, Watt. Back the other way to the left end goal. Chips one up as Frederick. Frederick back to Watt. Watt over to the far side for James Morgan, who sends one into the box. Barzola comes up, skies for that one again. Now Barzola will wheel it forward. Enman. And a long pass from Mills. Kicked out of bounds by Morgan. NGU with the throw in. 4:15 and counting to go with Lees-McRae up 2-0. Now a high, high deflection. Headed back by North Greenville, but picked right back up by Lees-McRae. And offside flag will go up. It's Thomas Dealey, who is running down the middle of the field. And Lees-McRae continued to try and use that speed, but called offside for the second time tonight.
Just a little mistiming. They get that down, they'll have that.
And North Greenville back on the attack. Vitor Tarpinian to Enman. Enman trying to weave his way around the defender and had a pass deflected, and Enman can't keep it in. Who's it off of? A goal kick for Pavlett. Well, Greenville looked like they thought they got a corner. Ooh, good cross by the referee, though. A little wide. And a goal kick for Pavlett. Now pressure provided by Lind. Pavlett has to get rid of it. Now a long pass to the far side from Watt. And chip up for number 11, Jesperson, into the corner, deflected up. Barzola again comes up to make the diving save in front of Dealey. 2.5 to go before halftime.
Definitely a two-goal lead at halftime, Gray, sets up your game a little differently.
It does, although I think the game plan for Lees-McRae right now, pretty simple. Keep using your speed to get behind the defense. It's worked one time, and their second goal coming off of a cross, so keep at it. North Greenville just really needs for these final 2 minutes to get in and take a shot. Here comes Enman, will flip one up, but it's off target, and a goal kick for Pavlett.
Coming into the game for the Bobcats, number 23, Tyler.
Number 23 checking in for Lees-McRae. Tyler Oakley And 16, Colin Fry. Goal kick from Pavlett, heads to the far side. Hits a North Greenville player first. Lees-McRae brings it down. And the Bobcats looking for one more goal before halftime. Out of bounds off North Greenville. Throw in for the Bobcats, taken quickly. Nathan Watt kicks it back. Somebody's got to track it down. There goes Morton back for it. Back to the keeper, Pavlett.
Just going to run the clock out now, Gray.
They send it back across midfield. And Lees-McRae works back down the field. Now they have a man running free down the near side, and the offside flag goes up against David Frederick.
And 30 seconds to go.
Third offside call here in the first half against Lees-McRae, but they lead by two. Lees-McRae trying to defend against the last second drive from North Greenville. Looks like they will be able to as Pavlett sends. Wow, he got a lot of leg behind that one. Made it all the way to Barzola at the edge of the box. 5 seconds, and Barzola looks like he's content to run the clock out. That's the end of one. Lees-McRae leads North Greenville in the men's game 2-0. And at the end of the first half, 12 shots taken by Lees-McRae, 8 of those on goal, none for North Greenville. No shots taken.
Have to give Bobcats defense a lot of props on that no shots, too. They've been having that swarming defense all night. Seems like there's always three players around the ball.
And Paul Vassart with those two goals for Lees-McRae, looking for the hat trick in the second half. Coming up next here on the North Greenville Sports Network. And back for the second half here on the North Greenville Sports Network. Lees-McRae leading North Greenville 2-0. And North Greenville will start us off here in the second half. And Dave, the message I would have for over halftime is plain and simple. Get down the field and take shots. North Greenville had no recorded shots that first half.
Exactly. They've got to get some shots on goal. They're getting down the field. It just seems like they're not getting anybody set up.
Lees-McRae has done an excellent job of stepping in the passing lanes. You've got to look at defenders like Kelvin Wood, number 20, and number 36, James Morgan, two of those excellent defenders. Paul Vassart is going for a hat trick here in the second half. Meanwhile, one bright spot for North Greenville looks to be Chris Inman. He did take an inadvertent elbow to the eye. He stayed in the game and continues to get behind the Lees-McRae defense. But the defenders are so fast, they close in on him, and he can't get anything done with the ball.
Bobcats are still having that swarming defense. Constantly two to three players around the ball at all times. Once again, we welcome you back to the North Greenville Sports Network. Men's soccer this evening. Beautiful night in Tigerville, South Carolina.
Yeah, almost full moon. So now the Bobcats going from left to right. North Greenville going from right to left. Barzola and Pavlet still in goal for both teams. And the Bobcats setting up, trying to transition to the middle of the field. Number 5, Nathan Ashburn. Midfielder, freshman out of Warlingham, England. Now to James Morgan. Back to Nathan Watt. Now number 8, Anders Stokes. And defended by North Greenville out of bounds. Throw in for the Bobcats, taken quickly. Backheel by Lind on the interception, and now he gets intercepted by number 6, Marvin Reiger. And again, sliding challenge out of bounds by Lynn. Throw in for the Bobcats. Each team heading it back and forth. Who's going to come down with possession? Bobcats get it. James Morgan comes back in retrieval. And here we go. To the far side, Wood sends it long down the field. Barzola comes up to field it, and he's got a fall on it because he has number 28 coming through the defense, Taylor Morton, to try and knock it away.
And once again, a reminder, our score is Bobcats 2, North Greenville 0. North Greenville has got to get the ball down in the zone and get a shot.
And might have a chance here. Here comes Seavers trying to break free, but Nathan Ashburn beats him to it, and now this ball popped way up and off the tent. Out of bounds. Throw in North Greenville. Still a chance for the Crusaders. Lind looking for number 24, who's now in the game, Cameron Ward. Referee signals foul against Lees-McRae. So a free kick for Cameron Ward and North Greenville. It's definitely in range, can do some damage here.
Bobcats goaltender was hanging on to the left goalpost, but now he's getting back in position.
Now, Jonathan Lind will line up. They fake it to Brady. Lind kicks it to Brady. Brady bounced it off a defender. Number 9, Paul Vassart, comes up with a big stop on defense. Out of bounds, though, off the Bobcats. North Greenville throws it in quickly to number seven as Tarpinian had a shot at it, and it's kicked out by the Bobcats still. NGU ball. 5 minutes into the second half, 40 to go.
Crusaders in no hurry. I'm not sure that's a good strategy at this point.
In position to try and get a shot as the throw in, Brady couldn't reel it in, and a turnover to Lees-McRae.
Yeah, that's what I was afraid of, a little bit too long there. Let Bobcats get set up.
And now it looks like the Bobcats have slowed things down on their end.
Yeah, it's a different game when you've got a two-goal lead. Your strategy is definitely different.
Now off the deflection, it's intercepted. Cameron Ward trying to break free, and he gets picked off by Nathan Watt. Now North Greenville able to intercept that pass again down the near sideline, trying to get something started. Lynn slips, and they turn the ball over again back to Lees-McRae. Now Nathan Watt turns on the Jets, fires a pass to Dealey, and the flag goes up against Dealey.
Yeah, offside again, Gray. A lot of offside calls tonight.
Four, now make it four against the Bobcats. North Greenville has one as well. Now Inman using his speed to get down the field, and this one is up, and it is good between the trees and out of bounds.
Yeah, I don't think they'll find that one.
Ooh, yeah, that one.
That's definitely down by the creek.
Good luck after that one. Allen says he'll go find it.
Yeah, he's got snake boots.
I don't know about that. Lees-McRae back down the sideline, number 10. Dealey in the corner. Fires a pass. Complete. Number 36, James Morgan. Now back to the middle of the field for the Bobcats. Up and over looking for Dealey. Dealey has a shot at it and stopped by Barzola just before the line.
Good stop again.
Bobbled it and then reeled it back in. North Greenville on the counterattack with number seven down the far side, Tarpinian. Tarpinian turns it over to Lees-McRae. Now he deems himself and gets it right back. Completes a pass to Ward. Ward trying to go long down the field. And bounces off of several players, and a handball call against North Greenville as they intercept the kick from Lees-McRae. Now Lees-McRae is going to be right back at it again. Number eight, Anders Stokes. Back to the goalkeeper, Pavlett. Morgan for the Bobcats. Back across midfield. Riger. Woods. Now Watt. Back up to Morgan. Open on the right wing. Morgan flips it into the box and just missed the header from number nine, Vassart. That would have been his hat trick. And now Barzola has to come up and make the save before Watt can get to it. And Watt took a little bit extra time getting up, knowing hey, let that one get away from him. Woods in the defensive half to Stokes. Down the far side, back number seven, Watt. To number nine, Vassart. And now Watt again as North Greenville finally able to put a stop. Mills gets the loose ball. Nathan Ashburn intercepts for Lees-McRae. And Gravely sends it flying toward the far side. Keeps it in play. North Greenville will continue on. Now across midfield. Good move. North Greenville into open space. Lind racing down the near side. Defender for Lees-McRae didn't get the touch he wanted. Here comes Lind. Lind back to the near side. Cross into the box. Headed back out by Lees-McRae. Tarpinian was open on the left wing. And now all the way back across midfield, Gravely to Barzola. North Greenville will start anew. Ball kicked out of bounds. Throw in for the Bobcats.
Ray, I've noticed that about the first 30 minutes of the game, the best player on the field was the Bobcats' Taylor Gray. And they took him out with about 10 to go in the first half, and he has not been back in since. He's warming up on the sidelines. But at first I thought there might be an injury there, but I don't think so. I think he's just resting.
Yeah, Gray from his forward position definitely providing a lot of speed off the edge for Lees-McRae. After his defense comes up with the stop, Gray was normally halfway down the sideline calling for the ball. Another foul against Lees-McRae. North Greenville trying to set up to take a free kick quickly. And Ward chips it, deflected off a defender, Morgan. Ward gets it back off the deflection. Fires a pass to Brady. Brady between two defenders, a long shot. It's off the keeper's hands, stopped by Pavlett, and he keeps it in play. And we'll have to get rid of it.
Almost caught the goalkeeper sleeping there.
Pavlett was still, he was late, but he still made the save. And that should go down as North Greenville's first shot of the night, and it was on goal. Now the counterattack from Lees-McRae.
Crusaders have to get more shots on goal. That just one in about 60 minutes is not going to be good enough.
Lees-McRae has 10 out of 14 shots on goal. And Quinn chases it out of bounds. Last off the Bobcats, goal kick for Barzola.
Coming in for number 7, Victor Tarpinian, is number 27, Shores Van Eck for the Crusaders.
And here's number 27, Shores Vanek, coming in for Vitor Tarpinian. Oh, and they did manage to find the ball.
They did. Wow.
2 for 2 tonight.
Actually, 3 for 3. They got the other two in the woods on the west end.
They did get that other one out. Good. So, okay, so 3 for 3 on found balls tonight. North Greenville trying to get out of their defensive half and form an attack. And they have Inman back there, and he can't get to it in time. Out of bounds off the bat, off the Bobcats. Coach Martin urging his team to go quick. As it's intended for Inman over on the far side, again out of bounds. It's off the Bobcats and number 28, Morton. Another throw in. Just short of the corner flag by about a few yards. Thrown in, now booted high, almost back to midfield, headed back on by Gravely. Now Pavlett has to come up after getting some help from Woods. And that puts a stop to that attack. Number 6, Riger. Number 5, Ashburn. Number 20, Woods. The back three for Lees-McRae. Now they try to send a man on a break. Barzola kicks it back. Here's Quinn. And Quinn at Joe Severs with the return. Got tripped up. Lees-McRae gets the ball back. Now the Bobcats with a chance. Far side into the box. Fires. Barzola stops. Number good. Two, David Frederick.
Good stop there. Looked like he had a breakaway.
That is his ninth save of the night. Barzola's been under a lot of duress from Lees-McRae and stops their 15th shot of the game as the Bobcats send a low cross cleared away by North Greenville initially. Cameron Ward got a foot to it. And now a long cross right to Barzola as another shot was on target. Now the keeper's throw intercepted. Here's number nine, Vassart, slinging it into the box, headed away by North Greenville. Once again, the Bobcats bring it back down. Number eight, Stokes got to it. The Bobcats have to chase the ball back all the way to midfield with Morgan. And now 10, that's Dealey, and nine, Vassart. And Casey Brady finally pulls the ball away from Lees-McRae, and now North Greenville can start. Crusaders get it across midfield, headed back toward the midfield stripe by Lees-McRae. And now Vanek breaking forward, but won't be able to get to it in time as he was guarded by Morgan, and the keeper Pavlet comes up to make the stop.
Goalkeeper was at risk of getting some injury there. Both those players coming right down on him.
Another throw in for North Greenville coming up after a substitute. Two substitutions for the Bobcats and looks like one for North Greenville. So here comes Taylor Gray back in, showing no ill effects. So, right, Dave, just some rest for him. Number 11, Paulette Jesperson back in as well for the Bobcats.
Coming in for number 12, Chris Simmons. Number 16, Matthew Woodington for the Crusaders.
And Matthew Woodington back in as well for the second time tonight. Bobcats again breaking free off the throw-in by NGU. Pass forward. Around the defense. Shot bobbled but caught by Barzola as Jesperson has a shot on goal. And now offside flag goes up against North Greenville. Both sidelines now really calm for both teams. Of course, Lees-McRae calm because they have a lead, but North Greenville is showing also a lot of calmness and patience on their sideline.
Exactly. No enthusiasm on the team at all. Need somebody to get that team fired up.
Now here comes Lees-McRae. Barzola up to make the stop. Doesn't get it. The shot will roll in. Third goal of the night for Lees-McRae. It didn't come from Vassart, so he'll still have to wait on his hat trick. Instead, it's the number above him, number 10, Thomas Dealey.
Crusader goalkeeper got the ball, but unfortunately he kicked it out to the side right to Lees-McRae player to put it right back in the net.
And that was Dealey's first goal of the night. And Bobcats right back on offense again. Number nine off to the races. That's Vassard. He's looking for a hat trick. He gives it to Dealey again. Dealey might have two quick goals back-to-back. And he fires it to Stokes. And it's picked up by Lynn for North Greenville. Now North Greenville counterattacking. Vanek can't get it. Picked off by Watt. A defensive stop by 18 Severs sends a pass long down the sideline, too far in front of Lind. And back to the keeper, Pavlet, who skies this one. and out. I think he's trying to hit us.
Take a pretty good kick to get it up here.
I think Pavlet's got the leg. As ball bounces around off several defenders. No clear possession yet. Now the Bobcats get it. Number 11 trying to break free, Jesperson. And the offside flag goes up against Jesperson trying to break through the defense. And Severs lets the ball go out of bounds. Couldn't get to it in time. And Lees-McRae trying to break back down the field on their own. They lose the ball out of bounds. 25 minutes to go in the second half. Lees-McRae leading by 3. 2 goals from Paul Vassart and 1 from the Englishman, Thomas Dealey, out of Oxford. Lees-McRae looking again as Barzola has to stop. He stops Vassart from getting his hat trick, but the rebound was almost put back in by Jesperson.
Yeah, he was very fortunate when he fed that ball back out. Lees-McRae got the ball back.
Now Seaver sends it back. Barzola wasn't ready for that. Now he sends it out. Lees-McRae with new life on offense. A backheel pass from Lees-McRae, but nobody behind Dealey to receive that one. So Barzola on to goal for the goal kick. Top of the hour, 9 o'clock here. And now James Morgan trying to break through on the right wing. Referee whistle and a free kick awarded to the Bobcats. Watt back to Woods. Back to Watt. Over to the far side. Pass into the box, bounces off Gravely. Bobcats bring it down. Do they have a shot? And the offside flag goes up against Frederick again. Goal kick from Barzola makes it to Seaver. Sees it. Seaver sends it down the field, and the offside flag goes up against Lind. And the official motioning to a couple players, a warning, no card, but a warning against the keeper, Pavlet, who came out to guard against Lind.
Well, he definitely saved a point there, saved a goal.
He did. So the clock continues on. North Greenville will slowly running out of time, and Lees-McRae sets it up for the free kick. North Greenville intercepts it, and now Lees-McRae intercepts it right back. Cameron Ward intercepts again for North Greenville, trying to send it down the middle, looking for Vanek, but it gets to the keeper, Pavlet, first.
And he's in no hurry.
Trying to keep it away from North Greenville because it's getting down to crunch time for NGU.
Yeah, 3-goal deficit with 21 minutes to go. It's doable, but they're going to have to hurry with only just a few shots on goal.
Number 8, Stokes. Number 14, Taylor Gray. Bobcats trying to attack from the far side. Running out of real estate. Into the corner, and rolls out. Be a throw-in for the Bobcats. Need some help over there on the far side. Nobody in the middle of the field and nobody on the right wing. And now a long shot on the way right to Barzola, who's standing in the last moment spot, I'll call it, as that one, if he bobbled that one might have rolled in. But Barzola has to drop back again. Here come the Bobcats. Stokes to Watt. Quinn sticks a leg out and kicks that one up. Bobcats regain control at midfield. Now some open space over on the grandstand side of the field. Woods has it. Arts Gray has it. Trying to break against Vanek, and Vanek peels the ball away, goes down the field looking for Wynn. Lind headed away by Woods. Lees-McRae once again regains control as the clock rolls under 20 minutes to go in the second half. Morgan over on the near side gets it. Now what?
Bobcats are happy just to keep passing that ball back and forth now.
Now a long shot that's going to go right to Barzola, who comes up to make the grab. And now 16 for NGU. That's Matthew Woodington as Ward intercepted by Nathan Watt. Watt on the near side edge of the box. Doesn't have anywhere to go, so he gives it to Vassart. Vassart still looking for that hat trick. Now Stokes chips it up. Vanek on defense, sticking close to his man, Taylor Gray. Gray trying to get around Vanek. It's out of bounds. And from its location, it will line up to be a goal. It will be a corner kick for the Bobcats.
Coming into the game for the
we have a goaltender change
for the Bobcats. They exchange Justin Brown, put him in, and Tyler Pavlett comes out.
Justin Brown from Charlotte, North Carolina.
And so Pavlett will finish tonight, unless he comes back in, with 12, or no, he will finish with one save. Got two substitutions as well for North Greenville, 3 and 28. Sam Robertson comes back in, and Sebastian Marmogello gets his first appearance in tonight's game. Corner kick cleared out by North Greenville. The Bobcats trying to turn it around, though. Gravely, the last line of defense, and Gravely comes up big. All right, it's Lind comes up big. As he was trying to peel it away from the Bobcats. Now into the box go the Bobcats again, and right in front of the goal, it goes across the goal and will roll out of bounds here on the near side. Ball to North Greenville.
Bobcats had that shot through the crease like they had earlier tonight
where
they got a goal.
Out of bounds again. Another miscommunication will cost North Greenville possession. And the Bobcats, good flip there by Jesperson. Driving in, kicks it up, man open, headed on. Barzola with the punch over the crossbar.
Very good, very good. He saw that one coming. Bartolo was right on the spot.
It'll be a corner kick for the Bobcats. Now it depends on which spot it went over the crossbar to which corner they set it up in.
Bartolo's listed at 5'9", but he jumps like he's like 6'3".
He definitely jumped higher than 5'9" there. Near side corner kick for the Bobcats. Number 10, Dealey to take it. Lines this one in. Kicked out by North Greenville. The Bobcats are going to get it back. Dealey tracks it down. Sends it to number 6. That's Riger. Now North Greenville trying to get him out of the box. It goes out of bounds and a goal kick for the keeper, Barzola. See if North Greenville can get down the field and test the new keeper, Justin Brown.
15:44 on the clock. They've got to get some shots. In North Greenville, just very few shots tonight.
One shot. And that one shot was on goal, though. As now, a shot lined up for number 7, Watt, curled away from him and right into the hands of Barzola. And Barzola will sky this one away. And now Jonathan Lind will try to make his way forward. Has Shores Vanek in front of him as well. They're looking for Vanek. It's out of bounds off the Bobcats, so North Green with some progress down the far sideline. Now the Bobcats get it back. Open space for Taylor Gray. Bounced it off a defender. Dealey picks it up, fires it back to Stokes. Stokes to 7, that is Watt. And now back across midfield to the back line for the Bobcats. Bobcats stacking up now 3 substitutions on the line. And this pass will make it past everybody straight to Barzola.
You're absolutely right, Greg. The Crusaders very stoic along the sideline.
And most of Lees-McRae team is up and running drills on the sideline, only one man seated. Now Lees-McRae. I think a goal would get him fired up, and now here goes number 16 trying to break free and bounce it off the keeper, but out of bounds. Matthew Woodington about had the break North Greenville needed, but dribbled it off the keeper then himself, and it will be a goal kick for Brown.
For the Bobcats, number 19, Nico Helbig.
3 substitutions coming on for the Bobcats. Number 15, Matthew Dunn, one of those. Number 19, Nico Helbig, and the other was 18, who returns to the game, Zachary Clay. Matthew Dunn, another Englishman on the Lees-McRae squad out of Slayford, England. Now the Bobcats press the attack. Here's a pass up for number 19. That is Helbig. And Helbig getting some touches after coming in. North Greenville trying to counterattack. Number 8 intercepts the pass. David Becerra. Now Brady. Mills going after it. And Mills can't get around his man, and he gets tangled up. And now Lees-McRae picks him off. Referee says play on. Pass looking for Vassart. And Paul Vassart gives it off. Chip shot up into the box, and the flag goes up against Frederick. And official stops. The referee stops the clock with 11:53 to go. Barzola with the goal kick. Takes a hop at midfield, headed back across the midfield stripe by Lees-McRae.
Don't give up.
And another pass goes wide for Lees-McRae, almost intercepted there. North Greenville trying to keep it clear. Number 28 trying to get rid of it, can't do it. That was Marmagello. Marmalejo.
Just can't say enough for the Bobcat defense tonight. They're all over the ball.
And now they are going for their fourth goal. Here comes the shot, saved by Barzola. And it's going to roll out. And Bobcats will set up for a corner. That shot from Paulie Jesperson.
Just under 11 minutes left in the game now.
Corner kick, bounces wide, and will roll toward the other corner flag and just go on the wrong side of it for a Bobcat throw-in. And now stolen away by Vanek. Vanek in a foot race down the sideline, fires a pass forward where it's picked up by number 16. And that is Woodington, who can't break through the defense. And a foul against North Greenville will turn it over to the Bobcats. And Bennett, good challenge there. Gives it to Marmolejo. And he goes deep, and miscommunication between him and Joe Severs trying to get that ball down the field.
A lot of players, Gray, on both teams breathing very heavy right now. A lot of bending over trying to get that oxygen.
Changes for both teams, a lot of changes for Lees-McRae.
Yeah, wholesale, just like the B team coming in.
I think you're right. Well, there was one change for North Greenville. We can go over. Chris Inman came back in. And yeah, I think Lees-McRae changed their whole starting 11. Well, if results hold for the Lees-McRae men's team, they will head into the doubleheader against Erskine undefeated in conference play, as we've entered that part of the college soccer season where, at least here in Division II, we play doubleheaders, as a long shot right to Barzola is saved. And 8.5 minutes to go. So next up for Lees-McRae, the men's team will take on Erskine as part of that doubleheader for the Bobcats on the 17th.
And very little rest for the Crusaders, as they're going to be going to Barton College on Saturday.
And part of that doubleheader, as I think the women's team is going up to Wilson as well.
Well, we'll see now if Lees-McRae's fresh legs show anything here, or if they're just going to play past the ball.
Nathan Ashburn with it, chips it up, looking down the field for David Frederick, led him too far, and right to the goalkeeper, Barzola. Now number 23 trying to knock it away from Casey Brady. That was Tyler Oakley. Oh, pass all the way back to the keeper, Justin Brown. You've got number 22 back there as well. That's Tyler Bossarge. Lees-McRae already back at midfield. Bounced off a North Greenville defender. Will stay with the Bobcats.
Very little running on either team right now. Everybody's just walking to their positions. 6:57, just under 7 minutes to go now.
Yeah, temperature definitely dropping. Water droplets starting to condense everywhere. Foul against North Greenville will give the Bobcats a free kick. Here's the kick. Defended by NGU. Can they get a breakaway? They're trying. The referee gets a gets in the ray. They have to dance around him. And Evan Mills finally sent it down the field. Now North Greenville trying to get down the field. Vanek, closest man to it, and just as Brown kicks it away and out of bounds, North Greenville will get it back with a throw in. Now we're off tomorrow here on the North Greenville Sports Network, but we'll return Saturday as we're back for Saturday night football against Newberry, but Crusader Athletics still in action. The women's volleyball team heads to Pfeiffer on Friday at 7 p.m. to continue their conference play. Women's volleyball got an opening conference win Tuesday night against Converse. As now a foul against Lees-McRae. Gives North Greenville a free kick. Also, women's volleyball here at NGU. 7-2 on the season. A good start for them. And another foul against Lees-McRae as North Greenville takes the free kick in almost record time. And now they're trying to work down the field. Cleared out by the Bobcats. North Greenville gets it back with Mills. And now just about everybody but two defenders and the goalkeeper for North Greenville is forward. And Johnny, and that's Inman, trying to track it down but can't do it. It's a goal kick for Brown.
Approaching 4 minutes left in the game, and it's all Bobcats right now.
Bobcats back across midfield. Sling it over to the far side. Shores Vanek on defense. Pass right to Brady. Now Brady sends it back to Vanek. Vanek to Marmalejo. And cut away by number 8, Stokes. Or it's 18, Zachary Clay. Barzola makes the stop, gives it to Brady. Brady to Marmalejo, back to Brady. Brady across midfield, chips it up for Inman, and again the offside flag goes up against Inman.
Well, they had the right idea. It's just the timing's not there yet.
11 total offside calls in this match, 7 of them against the Bobcats, and make that 4 against NGU.
Has very little to do with North Greenville's lack of shots on goal. They just can't get the ball down there. They have no offense tonight for some reason.
And now a long shot deflected off several defenders. And now a rebound shot will miss right from the foot of Tyler Oakley. Barzola with the kick. And Oakley almost able to step in front of that one before the pass got away. Pass down the field, out of bounds, intended for number 28, Marmalejo. Bobcats, 2 minutes left. Foul against NGU, and another free kick for the Bobcats. Far side cross all the way will miss everyone and hop out for a goal kick to Barzola.
.122 left to go. I think the Bobcats feel that they've got this one now.
And the official holding play for the moment. They hadn't started yet. Now they will.
1 minute to go.
1 minute remaining.
And now the Bobcats intercept the pass. They tried trying to tack on one more. Casey Brady suddenly forced on defense. Now the Bobcats run it back to midfield. And Ashburn sends it into the defensive half. Back to midfield. Ashburn again. Looking long down the sideline and deflected out of bounds by Marmalejo. Intended for Nico Helbig. Under 30 seconds. Lees-McRae trying to not press and let anything get behind him. 15 seconds.
Yeah, they're going to sit on the ball now.
10.
Back to Ashburn,
and
to number 22, Basarge, and now number 2, Frederick. And a pass to Frederick as he kicks it into the far side corner will bring us to full time. So Lees-McRae sweeps the doubleheader against North Greenville today in men's and women's soccer action. Lees-McRae now 2-3, 2-0 in conference play. North Greenville 0-3, 0-2. In conference play. Big number of the night, 22 shots for Lees-McRae, 17 of those on goal. One shot for North Greenville and the only shot on goal for the Crusaders. Barzola did come up with 14 saves, only one save for Tyler Pavlett for the Bobcats. Eight corners for the Bobcats, two for North Greenville. 11 total offsides calls. Both teams showed great speed tonight, seven. But they couldn't quite get the timing right down, as Davey mentioned. Seven offsides calls against the Bobcats, four against North Greenville. And Dave, you mentioned at halftime a player you liked in that first half, like number 14, Taylor Gray. And so Taylor Gray will get the player of the game.
Yeah, I agree with that call.
For this match, Gray. From his forward position, you wouldn't think a forward would get back there and play defense as much as he did, but he did. He joined number 20, Kelvin Woods, back there, as well as you had Zachary Clay come in, James Morgan back there as well, and Lees-McRae played really tough defense all night.
Yeah, and Gray, just being a freshman, he was a spark plug for the team. I think his enthusiasm, you know, actually was felt throughout the Bobcats team.
And still relatively young squad for Coach Wall going forward. You said four seniors, and most of, just glancing at the roster, that most of this team made up of freshmen and sophomores.
Exactly. They've got a lot of potential going forward.
And North Greenville is really more of the same. They have some seniors on there, but you look down the listing of list of class, mostly freshmen and sophomores there too. So two young squads.
Right. I'd like to see a little more enthusiasm out of the bench. It seemed like they were very stoic tonight.
So next up for the North Greenville Sports Network, for us here, Saturday Night Lights football over at Yount Stadium against the Wolves of Newberry College. That's a rivalry North Greenville needs to get back into, and get back into quick, as the Crusaders 2-0 after a one-point win over their future Gulf South opponent, West Alabama.
And then that 45-0 win last week.
And wasn't that something? North Greenville dominating Lenore Ryan in Hickory, 45-0. Will now look to take on Newberry here at home.
That's going to be an interesting game. Looking forward to the broadcast on Saturday night. We certainly appreciate everybody joining with us and staying with us on this doubleheader on the North Greenville Sports Network.
And so for myself, Gray Sutherland, Dave Parson, producer Alan Cahaley, and cameraman Alan Ellis, Christian Athey, and Mason Freitas, this has been Crusader Soccer on the North Greenville Sports Network.